Adam Show, brought to you through the facilities of the Dumont Television Network. Presented by your Dumont dealer, the man who holds the coveted Dumont Television dealer franchise. With Maury Amsterdam, Art Carney, Dottie Dean and Freddie Blair, Boots Orlanis, Mary Ann Drake, Leo, Limpy Blank, Nancy Donovan, Edna Thayer, and Johnny Guarnieri, his piano and his orchestra, at the Silver Swan Cafe. Dumont, first with the finest in television, proudly presents the Sherbrooke console with 19-inch direct view Lifetone picture tube, oversized chassis for longer life and superb performance, both AM and FM radio, and three-speed automatic record player, America's distinguished teleset. The Hanover console in classic pebble white design with 19-inch direct view picture tube, FM radio, and phonograph plug-in. Remember, there are 16 new and different models in both mahogany veneer and blonde hardwood made by Dumont. Dumont, the world's largest organization devoted exclusively to television and electronics. And now your Dumont dealer invites you to join Maury Amsterdam and the Happy Gang at the Silver Swan Cafe. That you're having such a wonderful time. Hurry back to your tables and chairs because it's floor show time again. And it's time for you now to meet the man who keeps things rolling here at the Silver Swan Cafe, your host, Maury Amsterdam. Welcome to the hot air conditioned Silver Swan Cafe.
Wow, what a day this has been. So hot this afternoon, I walked in the bathroom. The shower was taking a shower. Oh, it's been murderous.
Gee, it's nice of you people to show up on a day like this. I hope you brought your own electric fans and things.
Right after the show, we have Newton walk around and throw ice cubes at you. Keep you cooled off. Thank you for the nice applause when I came out. You ever notice how peculiar people are when they applaud? Everybody has a different way of applauding. For instance, there's a fellow who goes to a show, and this guy has been all over. He's seen everybody. You could bring Al Jolson out on the stage with Bing Crosby, Sinatra, Lana Turner, Esther Williams, the whole group. This fellow sits like this. Nothing. He has lived. Then there's a girl goes out with a fella her first date, and she wants to impress this fella. She's having a wonderful time. A stagehand can come out and move a chair. She goes, oh, isn't that swell? It's so wonderful. And then there's Scott. Did you ever see a Scotchman applaud? And then, of course, stenographers applaud like this. And then there's the other kind of a fellow who, he's always afraid somebody is talking behind his back. You don't want to take his eyes off of anything. He applauds this way. Then you get the people from New Jersey applaud this way. Airplane pilots applaud like this. Fella comes from a barber shop, works there all day, sits down in the theater, applauds like this. But no matter how you applaud, we'd like you to gather a lot of it all together, especially if you've been saving it for weeks and weeks. Make it up into a nice bouquet and present it to a very lovely young lady. This is about her umpteenth appearance in the Silver Swan Cafe. We love her, and I know you will, too. Nancy Donovan.
The way you look tonight.
Gee, I didn't think you noticed. Am I seam straight?
Someday, when I'm off, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight. But your so warm, there is nothing for me but to love you tenderness grows, tearing my fears apart. And at last that wrinkles your nose touches my foolish heart. Ah, but you're lovely. Never, never change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it?
Believe me, she's just as nice a person as she sounds and looks, too.
Will you say more,
now we have... Grover Whalen! What's the matter? What's the matter, Newton? Yeah. You out of breath?
No, I'm blowing up an invisible football bladder. Of course I'm out of breath.
What's the matter?
I was just at a wedding.
Well, what happened? I know
you... stopped a couple from getting married.
Who's a couple?
Me and my landlady.
Oh, come on. Don't tell me that she got you up to a justice of the peace.
Should have got me up in front of the Secretary of War.
What happened?
What a riot. Call that the riot squad. Cops come. Everything. What a mess.
Well, come on. Give me the gruesome details.
Trooper's friends pull her out of the police van 6 times.
What do you mean, trooper's friends? Why didn't you pull her out?
I was pushing her in.
Well, you certainly look like an ad for a Christmas tree or something. Hey! You really look like nothing with that outfit. Gee whiz. We're getting all set for the wedding and everything with that, huh? Well, come on, well, tell me what happened. Looks real nice on you.
I'm glad you asked.
Yeah, who made it?
Who made this? Art Schaffner and Gesundheit.
Well, Art Schaffner and Gesundheit.
The lining is made of Kleenex.
Well, that's pretty clever, and believe me, I'm sorry I asked.
I'm sorry, too.
Yes, well, tell me all about what happened. Hey, I'm going to tell you what happened. Yeah, go ahead.
Trooper, my landlady, you know?
Yeah.
She tried to trick me into marrying her, see?
Oh, come on.
So she gets on the phone, see? She's very clever with the tonsils, the impersonations.
Oh, that's right. You know, she was in vaudeville at one time. I think she did an act called A Woman of a Thousand Faces.
Yeah.
Look at what she wound up with.
Well, tell
anyway,
me what happened, yeah.
She tells me she's Ann Sheridan, you see? Oh, it does a beautiful job on Ann Sheridan. Me, I'm all excited.
On the phone?
You know? Yeah, on the phone.
Her, Ann Sheridan?
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
Well, I know. Of course, you and I know that you don't look like Ann Sheridan. General Sheridan, yeah.
No, I think his mustache was a little bigger. Anyway, she calls me up. You see, I can go along with a gag. I really think it's Ann Sheridan.
No kidding, on the phone.
I was excited, see?
I can imagine.
I can see myself at City Hall.
Yeah. And then you found out it was the landlady.
Oof. Back at the city dump.
Newton!
There she is. Miss Pot Cheese of 1892.
Newton!
See you later, kid.
See you later. Yeah. It's been swell.
Newton!
Wait a minute. Too late.
What's the idea of shooting me like this? What do you think I am? A dope? A moron? A nimbecile?
Keep going. Keep going. You'll find something that fits.
Oh, Mr. Amsterdam, just look at me.
Go ahead. You got a stronger stomach than I have.
Ow! Right on my foot. All right, I'm looking at you. What are you made up for?
Well, I know, but, gee whiz, you can't have me like this. I don't know what to say.
You don't know what to say? You look like if you're going to a wedding, where you're going to be married
well,
in a cave.
Well, have you know that I have an hourglass figure?
An hourglass
figure?
That's
true, that's true. The sand happens to be in the wrong place.
Look, I wore this dress especially for the wedding. It's been in my family over 100 years.
Wow.
Trooper, I didn't know you made it yourself.
How dare you? Why, I'll have you know that I've just reached 25.
What delayed you?
Now, wait just a minute. She doesn't look so bad. She looks like a society girl.
Yeah, humane society.
I'll have you know that my family happens to be the cream de la cream.
Well, don't see the cow. How do you do?
Oh, what am I saying?
Now, wait just a minute, Newton. You can't insult this lady.
No.
I know. I've been trying for 3 years.
Oh, Newton.
What?
Newton, is it true? Is
yes,
it true?
It's true.
That we're through?
True. T-H-R-E-W.
No, does this mean that we've come to the end of the line?
To the end of the line.
Oh.
Give me 2 cents. Here's your transfer.
Oh. Oh, you think you're a wise guy, eh?
She looks better
Listen,
that way.
Listen, I'll tell you this much. If you don't marry me, I'm going to see my lawyer.
Don't do any good. He won't marry you either.
Hey, boy, Andrew, that's real funny. I can't mess me up that day. Listen, Newton.
What?
Hey, maybe we shouldn't be laughing.
Why not?
Why not? She said she's going to see her lawyer. You know what this means? It means that you could wind up in jail.
Really?
Why, Newton, you could be in jail. But I'm your friend. I bring you cigarettes and I bring you coffee and tea and stuff like that to keep you happy.
I knew I could rely on you.
And I could see you there in that little cell. And then after a while, you won't be in that cell anymore.
Where will I be?
Where will you be? They'll take you through a little green door, into a little green room. And all of a sudden, they'll say, there's a chair. Sit down. Wait a minute. You didn't say, may I?
May I?
Sit down.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. And you'll be seated there in a chair. And all of a sudden, I have all kind of wires sticking out of your hair.
I'm getting a permanent?
No, no. It's the electric chair.
Electric chair?
An electric chair.
I'm worried. I don't know whether I'm AC or DC.
There you are. It's the electric chair. It's the last few minutes now. Prepare yourself. They're about to turn on the juice. There's only one thing you can say at a time like this. Only one thing. And you know what that is?
Yes.
Newton is crazy. He's a wonderful guy, though, and this is really a hot day to be wearing that outfit, isn't it? You know, incidentally, speaking of hot days, this is close to the end of summer. As we all know, most of the kids will be going back to school pretty soon, and they'll have to be going to bed early, and maybe a lot of them won't be able to watch our show, and we promised something special for them tonight. So this is for the kiddies, a little Arabian Nights story. It's about a sheik and his 3 beautiful wives, and they're in this harem, and he is very busy.
Thank you.
Dottie Dean, Bootsy Orlanis, and Mary Drake. Didn't think I'd remember the name, huh? Mary Drake. Sounds like a name in a mystery. Gee, I love that tune. What is that? La da 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 da. Here we are in Persia, and we hear one Persian calling to another. That's the first Persian a Persian call. Peanut, Popcorn, and chewing gum. You know, I've had a terrible rumbling in my stomach all day. Must be that truck I ate last night. You get the idea of rumbling, the truck I ate? A little song that I feel will break many records. There may be people who be breaking records to this song. Song that I wrote myself while under the influence of a barber son to ring a carbon-tightened poison. What did he say? Number entitled Mr. Group was ready to droop when his toop fell off and slipped in the soup. We sincerely hope you like that number. And now, listen to this number.
I heard. Oh, what I heard.
I heard. Yes, I heard. Though it wasn't told to me, still I heard. I heard. Yes, I heard. Though they didn't buzz to me, still I heard. Now she said that he said, but he didn't say where she got it. And they said that he said that no one was gonna top it. I heard, yes I heard. Though it wasn't told to me, still I heard.
Now she said that there is no other set like it. This beautiful new 1951 Dumont Mount Vernon console in simple Georgian design. And he said, her husband that is, that its performance just can't be beat. And they all say that Dumont's new Lifetone life-size 19-inch picture tube gives superb pictures. And the tone quality is really magnificent. And say, you know, the news is getting around all over the country that the new 1951 Dumont Mount Vernon is a magic carpet to whisk you away into a fabulous, fascinating world.
I heard, yes, I heard. Though it wasn't told to me, still I heard.
About the new 1951 models of Dumont Telesets, the Mount Vernon. By the way, I'll let you in on the news. If you'd like to see the 15 other new Dumont Telesets in the 1951 line, why don't you visit your Dumont dealer? And now, friends, the Silver Swan players take you on a trip to the farm, where one good churn deserves another. The title of our drama tonight is, She Gave Him a Package of Limburger Cheese, or The Farmer Takes a Whiff. This is Farmer Jones. You know, Farmer Jones has something on his mind, but he's biting his time. You know, you can tell he's a gentleman farmer
He's tipping his hat to a tomato. He's also a chicken psychiatrist. He's examining this egg because it's a little cracked. Farmer Jones has been raising pigs for years. In fact, he raised the biggest hog in the country. And here he is. This is the farmer's son, Hezekiah. He used to run the tractor, but the tractor couldn't take it. Farmer Jones wants to know what Hezekiah has been doing. Well, Hezekiah is going to tell him. Hezekiah says, I've been out pitching hay. He wants to know if Hezzy took care of the corn. He says, yes. Now Farmer Jones wants to know if Hezzy fed the cows. Well, he says he's been feeding the cows with $10 bills so that when they give cream, it'll be richer.
Nothing like you make me a headache!
He's saying, get out, you dope! This is the farmer's daughter, Kitty. Now, we call her Kitty because she has a cute puss. Farmer Jones says, hello, daughter. Kitty says, hiya, pop. Farmer Jones asks, flowers for me? What kind are they? Oh, they're early bloomers. Ah, ah, ah. Ah. Someone's knocking at the door. Is it a woodpecker? Is it a crow? And here she comes now. This is Miss Trooper Drizzlepuss. She's the richest woman in Buck's Teeth County. She's so rich, the eyes in her potatoes wear monocles. You see, Farmer Jones owes her $1,000 for a loan on the farm, and she wants her money. Farmer Jones says he's broke. On the farm, he picks apples, but at the racetrack, he's been picking lemons. Well, Miss Drizzlepuss says she knows from nothing. You see, when she picks it up, she'll tell him that she wants her cabbage, or else she wants him to marry her. You see, Farmer Jones is a grass widower. His wife ran away with a lawnmower. Lawnmower! Well, well, now Farmer Jones is giving her a real glassy stare or a cold shoulder. Miss Drizzlepuss says she's going to get a dispossess notice and that she'll be back in two shakes of a lamb's tail. Well, now, friends, things look pretty dark on the farm. But wait! Fate, in the form of a traveling salesman, is at the door. It's traveling salesman Maury. The doorbell is out of order, so he's wringing a towel. You know, for a long time, he's been on the road. And for a long time, the road has also been on him. Kitty asks him if he's hungry. He says no, but he'd like a spot of tea. It's love at first sight. She says, you're sweet. He says, you're a honey. Farmer Jones tells them to stop horsing around. By the way, that's a picture of a horse. Well, Miss Drizzlepuss is back.
She's telling Farmer Jones she has the dispossess, and if he doesn't marry her, it's curtains for him. The super salesman gets an idea. He tells Miss Grizzlepuss that Farmer Jones is not the man for her. He's got the ideal husband for her. He can make love 24 hours a day. He says he'll sell her a mechanical man. Well, now, this robot's got the kind of a face that only a motor could love. And here's Motor. Miss Grizzlepuss is happy, a man at last. She'll gladly pay the $1,000. Grizzlepuss is overjoyed. She always wanted a man with an iron constitution. So the super salesman throws in something for free.
We've had a real good time. We hope that you folks have too, as we said before. And by the way, to all you people who have relatives, friends, husbands, or wives over in Korea, be sure you, those fellas get a lot of mail, will you? They keep writing and saying, come on, let's get mail from home. So take care of them. Don, I think you have a message.
I would like to tell the people, Maury, that the Maury Amsterdam Show is directed by David P. Lewis.
Right.
And that Frank Bonetta is the production supervisor. The program is written by Joe Ahrens, Lee Sand, and Maury Amsterdam. Well, now, friends, this is Don Russell.
Yes.
If you'd like to go to your nearest Dumont television dealer, you'll see the latest styles in the new 1951 Dumont telesets. Once you get down there and give them a look, 16 beautiful new models to choose from in both mahogany veneers and blonde hardwoods.
Right.
We want you to do that right away, because remember all the time that Dumont is first. With the finest in television.
This has been a Dumont Network teletranscription.